I'm Katrina, and this is Sew and Tare. And now is the week of review of the week of February the 7th, 2022. Enjoy.
This was a pretty good week. I got to spend lots of time with the chickens. I usually don't get to spend lots of time with the chickens because I am working and it gets late and all that. Oviraptor has recovered from her molting. Her feathers are beautiful again. Rexy's being her great self. And Smilo decided that she might be laying eggs soon. She's going in and out of the nest box quite a bit. And the birds are still enjoying their feeder. I had to refill it today. They were sticking their whole heads in there. It was so funny. And this is how chickens sleep, but it's messed up because Oviraptor's usually in the middle. Not sure what happened. This week is a week of rebirth, and these are all tomato seedlings. And there's some pepper seedlings in there, too. You can hardly see. And Parmesan. We have tulips coming up in the yard, which is exciting. And all the flowers are starting to bloom. These ones I actually planted, but some of them are coming up. Like this daffodil. And then next one is the lemon verbena is starting to leaf out, which is exciting. And one of the plums is starting to flower in the front. I also have a quail that has been laying really dark eggs. And this week it's extra dark for some reason. On Tuesday, I came in to check on Meatball and found her like this.
You guys see the babies moving? I think that's what we're seeing. How you doing, sweetheart? Looking to move. You have little jumpers in there, lady. They're ready to come out, I think. Look at that. I hope this is picked up on the camera as much as I'm seeing it.
The next day, Meatball was skinnier. She had her litter that next morning. 10 babies. And then they are so naked at the beginning, and then they start fuzzing out, and then growing and growing. And by the end of the week, they were almost fully white. No pink, hardly at all, except for the ears. So cute. So in the pruning video, I told you guys we're going to have flowers on this peach tree. And look at that. So many flowers. Everything is starting to bloom in the garden. We have the Anna apple in the front is starting to go into full bloom. This is an early apple, so it's usual for it to be like that. The avocado had one flower open. It was so nice to see. I wasn't quite sure how this golden currant was going to do with no water, but it's leafing back and it's going to bud out with flowers. Quail were having fun in the sun. All every day is a good day when that happens. The volunteer celery is looking lovely. And the artichokes are growing with gusto. They've all taken good root and are growing really nicely. I even had some celery in with the artichokes. I did not plant those as volunteers. I also have dill in with artichokes. I planted this last year, not this year. Miss Tortellini is being a really good mom to her 4 babies, and they are growing so quickly. They fuzzed out very nicely. They have milk bellies and all of that. And they are so cute to watch. I have a little video clip of them while they're sleeping and moving around. It's quite cute. Here are a couple of tortellini's babies at the end of the week. They're getting quite large. They're about a week old here. The quince is in full flower right now. It's very pretty to see, and the bees are starting to be all over it. We still haven't gotten any fruit off of this. And I did something. Made strawberry tower, so there's going to be a video on this later. The daffodils continue to bloom. We still have one more variety that hasn't bloomed yet. So we have two in bloom right now, and one is still waiting. It's nice to have that rotation. And the tulips are coming up. Hopefully, we have tulips for next week. The narcissists are blooming in the front. We have flower buds on the plums. Tomato, volunteer tomato. And this is a volunteer tomato from last year that's still growing and has flowers already. This is February. This is ridiculous. We also have some garlic chives that are coming back from the root. But this weekend was 80 degrees. 80 degrees. Not normal for February, but the grow-outs were doing great with it. I did put up some shade for the ones in the screen and porch, and they were doing great. And you see this little quail? There's two of them. It's hilarious. They were dust bathing in the chips. There's two of them. They're below the ground level. It's so funny. Anybody guess what this is? It's not done yet. Almost there. Now, here's something exciting that I forgot about. And we had a little adventure after pulling them out. Carrots.
All right, so I wasn't sure if we got one or a few carrots because I know that not all of them grew. And so I just pulled up three carrots. I don't remember the kind. Look how huge this top is. But Manuel has never had a fresh carrot, right? Wanna try
Nope.
this one?
It is very old.
Very old? Okay, I'm gonna break off the tip for you.
Okay.
You can try it on camera. Ooh, look at that. Show the camera. You snapped it. What do you think?
Tastes good.
Is it juicy? As far as carrots can go.
Pretty sweet.
So now you know why I'm growing carrots.
Are you growing more
I will be.
or just those?
I will be growing more. Good reaction. They're so juicy when they're fresh. Like, if you've never had a fresh carrot, you don't really know what I mean by it being juicy, right? It's juicy.
Yep. Pretty fresh.
Pretty fresh? Well, it is very fresh. We literally just pulled it and washed it, and now you're eating it. It'd just be fresher if you, like, didn't wash it first, but then it would have dirt.
Don't want it that fresh.
All right, plant carrots, they're super juicy.
We're giving the quail some. They've not had greens yet, I don't think. And Ziti, she's had carrot tops before. Oh, baby.
So no babies yet?
No babies yet.
Did you arrange it or she
Nope,
did?
she did that. That's what he's talking about. They see I have greens. There you go, sweeties. They love their greens. Hi, ladies. Here. Yeah. All right, here you go. Look at these ladies. They smell it. Oh boy. Oh boy. So they've had this before, and they're much more excited about it than Ziti was.